So I've toyed for a while now with the idea of making some kind of synthesizer, but it just seemed like a project of a scale that was way outside my ability. But then I asked myself, okay, so what about just a single oscillator controlled by a variable resistor? That should be doable, right? So then the question becomes, okay, so how do you make a variable resistor that's actually fun to play, that makes sense musically, right? So here's what I came up with. So you just take pencil and paper and nice rectangle. So what you have here is a really thin layer of graphite on paper. And now graphite is actually a really good conductor, but this layer is so thin that it actually has quite a significant resistance across. And so then if you were able to put one terminal here and you had a tap, then you could, that's a variable resistor, and that would be sort of more fun to play than just a knob. So you take a pencil and you want to put a little screw into it to make contact with the graphite in the middle. And this pencil wood is so soft that I'm just gonna make a pilot hole with the screwdriver. So hopefully now that screw is making contact with the graphite inside, and you can make sure by just testing the connectivity between the tip of the pencil and the screw. And now the other end of the variable resistor needs to go to something which can connect to the paper. Fold that over. That paper clip on one end, and then where you touch that gives you different resistances. So now what about the oscillator circuit? So I found some of these in one of those light controllers that control the the string lights, and this looks like a transistor, but what it actually is apparently a kind of thyristor, an SCR. So I think that stands for silicon controlled rectifier, and I found an oscillator circuit that uses one of these, and the frequency is controlled by a resistor, and it's really, really simple. And so that's what I have over here. So now this is actually a modified version of that circuit. Basically, the resistor they had to control the frequency was a lot smaller than I can realistically get with graphite on paper, so I added this transistor over there and a variable resistor to limit the current, and the transistor to sort of beef up the current that was coming through this thing. So now let's see if we can get a sound out of this. A few things that I found sort of work well here. Number one is putting stiff cardboard behind the paper. Number two is using some folded aluminium foil as a pad to sort of spread out the force and the area of electrical contact underneath this paper clip, like that. So another thing is you want to make sure you have your horizontal lines, but then you also want some vertical lines. This helps with sort of the reliability I've found. Right, so here we have it all set up, and so this paper clip is connected here, and if you touch the pencil to this end of this graphite rectangle, you're the furthest away from the paperclip, and so the resistance is highest, and so you get the lowest pitch. And as you move towards this, you get higher pitches. And as you can hear, it's a little a little unsteady, but that you can actually improve with, you know, different kinds of paper and putting it on a hard backing surface and a bunch of other things, which I'm going to try and do, set it up a little better and play something in just a little bit. But first, a couple of things about the circuit. So this circuit, actually the original says that the speaker is an important part of the circuit because it acts as an inductor, and so that needs to be there. You can't just put an output jack and expect it to work, although I have put an output jack in parallel with the speaker. I put a resistor and a capacitor in series with it to make sure that no big signals go out and damage things. I'll put a schematic for this whole thing up, you know, including the pencil and everything. I'll put a link to that in the description. Another thing, this variable resistor, that is basically some kind of tuning adjustment. It limits the total current going into the circuit. If you have that set to the max, then it's kind of the safest. But if you set it lower, you can actually go higher in pitch. But then the problem is sometimes when the current gets too high, the whole circuit kind of just saturates and stabilizes and you stop getting oscillation at all. It kind of feels like a car stalling. So let me see if I can demonstrate that. So if I turn this, you know, down, you see it's just stopped. Just stopped. So you can play around with that depending on what kind of you know, graphite paper setup you have. Different settings on that might be best. About the paper, rougher paper seems to work best because it just holds more graphite. And so, you know, I'm going to do that. I'm going to sort of set it up. Let's cut to that now.